buddy. No, no, we don't want to do that. Because you're so cool, come here. Because you're the coolest dog I've ever known. I love you too. You're a sweetheart. How are you from home with me?
In the middle of a great bike heist, a thief in San Diego gets interrupted by a fluffy and lovable golden retriever. And it allowed him to essentially take a little bit of a pause, a little bit of a break in his criminal activity in order to share love with this sweet, sweet puppy that honestly is not a good guard dog at all. I'd be really upset. I'd be really upset with my dog for doing that. But nonetheless, I think this story really highlights my internal bias. And I think it's really important for me to be honest with the audience about what my biases happen to be. Before I do so though, one more video.
Where's your dad? Where's your dad? She's not out to leave your garage open. Dad, where are you? I love you too. I love you too, buddy guy. You guys, come on here. How do you have so much in your house? How do you have all this stuff? Dude, remember the coolest dog ever? Where's your dad?
So he ended up stealing the bike, but he did offer a word of advice to the golden retriever's dad. Tell your dad, don't leave the garage door open.
Yeah, fair. Since Anna's obsessed with dogs,
I
just check it every once in a while, I get the reputation of not loving dogs. Not remotely true.
No, deserved.
Okay, not at all true. And in fact, to prove it, I'll say about this story, let him go.
No, don't let him go.
I know you can't let him go.
The cops are looking for him. The San Diego Police Department needs help figuring out who this guy is in order to get the bike back. By the way, that theft happened on July 15th, so.
Yeah. They got him working in shifts, man. Leads. Okay. Anyways, so look, I know you can't let him go, but you're not going to spend a lot of resources trying to get him either. Have I seen worse hardened criminals? Yes. And the dog, you love him, you root for him. But Anna's right. Worst guard dog ever. If I'm watching that video and I'm his owner, I'm like, brother, you're going to do me dirty like that? After all these years we spent together, you're gonna be like, oh, you're gonna roll over with your belly to the thief, dude. You can't roll over to and show your belly to the thief.
I know, but okay. He's so lovable. He or she, I don't know what the the sex of the dog happens to be, but look at how cute and sweet. It just wants love. Give me love. That's the thing about dogs. Unless you get like a Rottweiler, which by the way, I'm sure Rottweilers are very sweet to their owners. But the reason why I would like to get a Rottweiler if I ever own a home is because I think a Rottweiler would protect you. But Christian's against Rottweilers. He's like, no, we're gonna get a golden doodle.
Okay, I don't know what a golden doodle is.
It's not a Rottweiler, let's just put it that way.
Okay, but I like golden retrievers.
Golden retrievers are sweet.
They're super sweet. So
why can't dogs like overpopulate the country?
Well, they could if we don't.
Instead of having like, I don't even know what the number is at this point, like 5 guns for every person in the country, what if we had 20 dogs for every person in the country?
Interesting new ideas by Kasper here. Policymakers, you listening?
Vote for me.
Vote for me. 20 dogs for every person. So seriously, now we go to the Dave Kohler principle, although that's not too serious either.
No, he's right. Go ahead.
So Dave Kohler's principle is, no, I don't have to lock my doors.
Oh, no, he's wrong. My bad.
Okay, all right. Well, that was quick.
Theoretically, he's right. But I think we as humans need to be realistic about other humans. you're gonna get robbed and you're gonna get burglarized. So like, it's 10:30 at night, bro. Like, why do you have your garage open, especially when you have like a billion bikes in your garage?
No, it's brazen. Or maybe they forgot. But anyways, so Dave's one of the co-founders here, and you'll see him on Old School every once in a while. And so Dave's car got broken into one day. Actually, it wasn't broken into. They just opened the door and stole some stuff. And we're like, Dave, why didn't you lock your door? And he's like, no. I don't have to lock my door. It is 100% the responsibility of the thief to not rob me of my possessions. Okay. While, and as Anna said, while theoretically true, lock the freaking door.
Yeah.
Close the garage door, then Mr. High Thief over here can't walk into your garage and walk out. I mean, I don't know if he was drunk. I don't know if he was high.
He was on something. Right,
but he was
slurring his words.
Yeah, you're a good dog. Where's your daddy?
Oh, by the way, I'm sure other dog owners slash pet owners already know this, but in case they don't, just a life hack. Get stoned and just like pet your dog or cat and just massage the crap out of them. It feels so good. They love it. They appreciate it. It's a stress reliever. That's why he did it, right? He's feeling good. That fur probably felt real nice.
Yeah. I thought for sure that he's high. I mean, look, but I gotta give the credit to the guy, one, for taking the time out to pet the dog. That's awfully humanitarian of the local thief. And number two is, this guy's got some, I mean, he's got a sack that Crowder would tap. Let's put it that way. Because he's,
I mean,
like,
it's so big, how could Crowder miss it?
Right, I mean, if you don't like sack tap, this is not the place for you. Anyway, that's from a different story. So this guy's like, he walks the bike back into the garage.
Yeah.
Just to pet the dog.
And calls out for the dad.
He calls out for the dad,
Where's your dad? Dad!
He's so high. He's definitely high.
Yeah.
Right? But either way, he walks back. And then, like, in the garage is the most lighted garage in America. And he's still playing with the dog, taking bikes out of there. And another reason to let him go is the dog came out of the house. That door was also wide open.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dude, such a good point.
He could have just walked in and taken anything he wants, but he was like, he was a reasonable thief. Pets the dog, takes the bike, and goes.
Should he keep the bike?
No, he shouldn't keep the bike. If he returns the bike though, let him go. Let him go.
I hate when I see the human side of a thief like this, right?
Yeah.
You see the human side. You see him loving the dog, and how could you not root for him after that?
Yeah. I hear you. Criminal, stop it, all right?
And that's my bias.
Okay.
If you love dogs, maybe I'll give you a little slap on the wrist, but that's it.
There's a lot of slapping and tapping going on in this story.
I won't tap anything, okay? That's for the husband, but that's I'll give you a slap on the wrist.
That's not helpful either.
He likes it.
Okay, all right. I'm not getting into any golden doodles. Okay. Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.